last but not least, Ms. Vagianou from Deree, American College of Greece. She will give this is the head of the Information Technology Department there. So, looking forward to it.
I had to revise my presentation so that it is shorter and I repeat lengthier than the class presentation. And there is a bit that was not covered. And I was very happy about this because at some point I did panic because it includes gender codes, the bit that was not covered. And when I saw there from our earlier speaker the gender coding, but I said to myself, what am I going to talk about? But before I go ahead with this, I would like to make a short, brief introduction to say a couple of things about me and a couple of things about the topic that I was going to present and how it is related to what I will present after all. So I have been with the American College of Greece for a total of 30 years with a couple of breaks only, short breaks. And actually, I have been there in all sorts of, I have been working with information technology in all sorts of ways. I have been assigned operational administration position, academic administration positions, I have been teaching. I have been leading a number of in-house projects, at least 12 important IT projects I led throughout the years. And even though I stayed in the same organization for so many years, I do feel like I have been changing well over and over and over again. Now, why did I do this? Well, it came effortlessly. I have to admit that I was very lucky, and for 15 years out of the 30 years that I am there, for 15 years I was working under a specific person, the mentor, let's say, who trained me somehow. I grew up next to him, I learned from him and so on. And after 15 years, he retired because it was time for him to retire. I was lucky that I was working with this person for all the reasons that I mentioned, but there was one thing that I really didn't expect. And I found out when he retired, and I was quite old, let's say, I was not older, but I was in my late 30s. I suddenly found out that I was lacking a specific soft skill. And that soft skill that I was lacking had to do with dealing with colleagues. When this person was around, he was dealing with everything, he was arranging who is going to do what. The competition, there was some kind of competition, but there was no questioning of who is going to do what. All the tasks were assigned accordingly. And when he retired, I had to fight for my right. And I didn't know how. And I was in my late 30s. And that didn't help me much. The first time I didn't realize what was happening, I got a kick. And also it felt like. And I was not certain what was happening, and I forgot about it in the next 2 minutes. It was over. I forgot about it. And then again, after a month, I got another kick. And I started panicking. And what am I going to do? I want to say here that it took me at least 5 years to learn how to deal with these situations. And I believe that all this had to do with the fact that I had to deal with my colleagues after I had worked for a very long time. It was not there, that soft skill. How to collaborate in a competitive environment. Not how to collaborate, but suddenly the environment became extremely competitive. Now, this is related to our talk today, to what I wanted to say today, from the perspective of, with regard to the soft skills that women that are in the world of IT and ICT and in general computing fields, these soft skills that the women need to have or are expected to have. Now, why am I isolating this, or why am I referring to women specifically? The reason that I'm referring to women specifically has been covered from all the earlier presentations, because there is some discrimination, or there has been discrimination for a very long time. But as I said, I believe that all this was covered, and on the other hand, we also saw that the reasons that women are not so much involved with computing has been attributed to the fact that what? They lack specific soft skills or specific attributes. I don't know. I don't want to make a conclusion because I have already argued this twice. And I'm not sure if there is enough evidence on this. But I would like to present I just want to present another perspective that has to do with the areas that women are choosing to be involved with computing. So, Robert L. Glass, in 2012, he published an article about the gap that I produce in the computing field, and in fact, in this article, he was arguing that it's not that women cannot make it well in all computing fields, in all computing disciplines, and they are afraid of the domain about it because of this. It is that women have he argued that there may be evidence that supports that the problem of women, that the problem of this, that this reluctance that women have is more related to computer science, if not more specifically with programming. And he argues that because in the gender codes, there is a chapter, as he says, that was published by an NIS researcher, an information system researcher. And if in general we consider that ICT, informatics, or whatever the name will be, consists of various sub-disciplines, the idea was that all the observation that he made was that all the enrollments that were peaking in the mid-80s, while were peaking at the mid-80s, but then were declining, but all these enrollments were of CS, of computer science. Whereas the percentage of information systems, there was a 37% there, which remained at the same level throughout the years. So based that this is his argument, he doesn't give an answer. He doesn't take, I suppose that he wants this to be researched further, if that is the case or not. He doesn't give an answer, but he does, I do see that, that he has a very interesting point. Now, considering that I had to present this, and considering the two arguments that I had earlier, I had started wondering if there are actually attributes that women have, or better, some attributes are stronger in women, and that's why in specific fields of ICT, they are engaged without fluctuations, serious fluctuations, or it was just a coincidence. That's all. Thank you very much.